Hey, let's go Buffalo, let's go Buffalo. The Buffalo Bills are 2-0 and they're heading into their home opener against the Cincinnati Bengals, Chalk Talk Episode 8. And this is our preview matchup right here. The Cincinnati Bengals come in town to play the Buffalo Bills. Andy Dalton, Joe Mixon, a little injured. And we got John Ross and AJ Green is still no go for this week. I don't think he comes back until week 5. So that's the matchup we're looking at. Now let's talk about the Buffalo Bills the last 2 weeks. And we're talking 2 road wins, 2 victories, same stadium. They said that we were going to end Eli Manning's career. Ironically enough, it didn't happen in the game, which good. Nobody wants to get hurt there. But he got sat for Daniel Jones. So that's kind of crazy that that happened there. But now let's review those games. The Jets, you could argue what type of Darnold are you getting, but they were winning that game when we came back. We already discussed that. A win is a win. It doesn't matter. Coming back on the road to get the victory, credit all day for the Buffalo Bills. First, the New York Giants. Saquon Barkley came out of the gate. I mentioned something to my neighbor. I said, and to someone, don't be surprised if they come out of the gate with Saquon Barkley right away and start running that ball. And even if he does well. And what do? He came out and he did it. But he was kind of quiet ever since. I mean, I know he had some bigger plays, but we were already ahead by then. But that touchdown had everybody a little nervous, including myself. But I listened to my own and I said, don't get worried about it. And Barkley still had his fantasy points for everybody out there. And you know that. But after that, there was really nothing. Buffalo's defense pretty much shut the Giants down, you know, and it was very impressive to see. And we got the 2 turnovers that I discussed and I talked about from our defense. We're going to see a lot more of that. Nice job by Ed Oliver to bat that ball down and Trent Murphy to go pick that up. That's hands on the ball right there. That's Buffalo Bills football. That's what we're going to see from now on. Mark my words. And, you know, Poyer with a beautiful layout touchdown towards the interception towards the end. Excellent. Just and on the offensive side of the ball, we got Josh Allen. Josh Allen is our future. He's our quarterback. And man, did he look good. Looked poised again in the pocket. He had an incredible pass to Dawson Knox, rolling out, fired and rifled it in there. That got national coverage. Outstanding. He ran outside the pocket early in the game and ran to the sidelines for a couple-yard gain. Stiff-armed defender, also got national coverage. A lot of these people are on the media side are covering Josh Allen, and he's getting a lot of high praise. We've seen some of it towards the end of last season, but now we're really seeing a possible, you know, topic that's going to stay. Josh Allen looked good. Now, by no means are we crowning him king or anything like that, but he's showing progress and he's showing the right necessary steps, and that's all you can ask for. Josh Allen through 2 games was 43 of 67. That's 64% in the pass attempt completion and 507 yards passing, 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions with that. And you can also tack on 17 rush yards for 59, or 17 attempts, I'm sorry, for 59 yards and 2 touchdowns. That's 4 touchdowns in 2 games from our boy Josh Allen. 2 in the air, 2 on the ground. Can't be mad at that. There is only 4 teams in the AFC that are undefeated. One of them we know is our Buffalo Bills. The other 2 are the Patriots, Baltimore Ravens, and the Kansas City Chiefs. Baltimore's kind of in that tier with Buffalo, and then you got the 2 elite, Kansas City and the Patriots, unfortunately. But for Buffalo to be up there, I don't care, through 2 weeks, that's some good company to be in right there. That's some good company. And remember, Bills fan, with a defense like we have, defense wins championship. I'm fine. Playing any team, I'm fine. I'd love to play a team like KC in the playoffs and get there, you know, obviously. The home opener versus the Bengals. That is our next game. That is our next focal point. And it seems like everything this week so far is going well. I know Devin Singletary was held out of practice today. I'm still not too sure. I'm not even really sure what they said, but I did hear that he was held out. So I don't know what that's going to mean. Step in TJ Yeldon, I think. And Frank Gore started to look good. So I think you'll be seeing more doses of them. Expect that. So, and the receiving side, you know, again, very fluid receiving receptions from our receivers, looking good from Josh Allen. Cole Beasley had 4 catches this past week for 83 yards. Brown had 7 for 72. McKenzie had 2 for 40 and a touchdown. They counted that little flick pass to him as a touchdown, as they should. It's a forward pass. And McKenzie looked good. That was a beautiful play call there. Giants never expected that. And they get in the end zone. You know what I mean? And they went. Buffalo was ahead the whole time. We're never trailing. And they looked that way. And they looked that way the first week as well. Gore had 19 attempts for 68 yards and a touchdown. A critical punch it in touchdown at the end there. You got to love that. That's what Gore's for. So Singletary had 6 for 57 and a touchdown. You know, a lot of good things we're seeing out of Buffalo here. And where do we go from here? How do we step it up a notch? I want to see that in the home opener against Cincinnati on Sunday in a few short days. How are we going to dial up different things? John Ross is quick. You know, they, even though it was a garbage touchdown at the end last week, you can't underestimate him. Joe Mixon is back and he's healthy. You can't underestimate him. Andy Dalton, we know, is kind of that quarterback that's an average that can be slightly above. That sometimes we consider that with him having A.J. Green, but he's got some speedy receivers, so you can't really count these guys out. But impressed with the Bills, and I'm confident that we're going to have a really nice game plan for Cincinnati. So far, 6 TD drives from the Buffalo Bills of 70 yards or longer. Last year, we had 14 70-plus yards TDs all season. So, I mean, we're already almost halfway there, and that's incredible. So that's some good company to be in as well. We're down at the 2. We were down at the 2 over there, and we drive all the way back. That's the type of things you want to see from our Bills. Guys, home opener, Bills Mafia, be loud. Let's get this stadium amped. You can feel the rumbling now in the stadium. Everybody in Buffalo, Bills fan, mediocre fan, you know, not that into football. When the Buffalo Bills are doing good, everybody is enjoying their weekdays. And Mondays are great. Tuesday, every day is great when the Bills win. And I can't wait for the weekend. Let's make sure that we go in and we handle our business on our home turf. Josh Allen, number 17, the Buffalo Bills franchise, is going to take care of business on Sunday. And then the Patriots are coming. Now that could be a nice matchup. And are they just going to run over us on our home turf, assuming we win the Cincinnati Bengals game? I don't think so. Bring AB in here. Bring everybody. We want that true test. Go Bills! Comment, like, subscribe, guys.